Hi, in this video, we want to talk about how to load .mat files in Python programming language, and also how to convert .mat files into CSV file in Python programming language. So please stay tuned. So first of all, suppose that we have a .mat file, which is a matlab file, and we want to load that into Python. So the first step is we should know the path of this file. So I should right click on it, then go to properties, and then go to security. And remember to drag from left to right, not vice versa. And I should copy the path, and I should go to the Python. So now, first of all, we should type from scipy.io import load mat, because you want to use that load mat in order to load matlab files into Python. And we simply use load mat, and we should pass the path of that file. And here is the path. And remember to put this R before this string. And it means raw text. It means consider this text as it is. Because if you don't put this R before the string, you have two options. The first option is to convert all the backslashes into two backslashes. And the second choice is to convert all backslashes into forward slashes. So remember to put R before this string. After all, you store the results in a variable, let's say called data. And now if I print the data and if I run the code, we can see that here is our data. But in order to get a better sense of this data, we simply print data.keys. And if I run the code, you can see it has some keys, header, version, globals, and SN. And this is the name of our data set. The name of my data set is SN. Remember that the name of your data set is going to be different, but the name of my data set is SN. So I should use this name. So I simply type data, and I should pass that name, which is SN. And I store that in a variable, let's say called X. And if I print the X variable, and if I run the code, we can see here is our data. And also let's print the type of X. And if I run the code, you can see that it's a numpy ndarray. So here's how to load .mat files, which are matlab files, into Python programming language with the scipy package. But here is a question. How can we convert .mat files, I mean matlab files, into CSV files in Python programming language? In order to do so, you should simply use a package called pandas. So I should import pandas as pd. And remember that this package is not a built-in package in Python, so you should install it first. Then I simply type pd.dataframe, and maybe you ask, what is dataframe? Dataframe is basically somewhat similar to rows and columns in Excel file, but in Python programming language. And we should pass X because you want to convert this X into a dataframe. And then we store the results in a variable, let's say called df, or whatever name you want. And then I should simply type df.toCSV because I want to convert that data frame to a CSV file. And I should provide a path for the output location. So for example, let's provide a path like this, for example, data.csv. And if I run the code, and if I go to the folder, you can see the file has been created. But if I open the file, you can see that we have an extra column, which is the index column that the pandas package has created. But we don't want that column. So in order to remove that column, you should simply type index equals false. It means that you don't want the index. And if we run the code again, now we can see we don't have any index. But also, maybe you want to change the name of these columns, for example, to x1 and x2. So in order to do that, you should go to Python, and here you should simply type columns, and you should provide the names. And remember that in that data set, I have two columns, so I should provide two names. The first name is for the first column, and the second name is for the second column. And now if I run the code, you can see it gives us an error because the file is open, so I should close it, and then I should run the code again. And if I go to the file, now we can see we have two columns, X1 and X2, and here is our data. Now I really suggest you to watch this video, which is on the screen now.